Welcome to The Joy of Music. My name is Diane Bish, and I would like to invite you to join us today as we take you on a musical journey of Normandy, France. Along with the beauty of its scenery and its quaint villages and cities, Normandy is a region of majestic churches and cathedrals. Today on the program, we bring you music from the historic houses of worship in a program entitled A Musical Journey of Normandy. Thank you for joining us. Our musical journey of Normandy begins in Rouen, one of the most picturesque and beautiful towns in all of France. Above anything else, Rouen perhaps is best known for its churches. The famous Cathedral Notre Dame is a Gothic masterpiece, often featured in the paintings of Monet. The Église Saint-Ouen, also a Gothic church, was once a Benedictine abbey. And among other outstanding features, it is highlighted by its beautiful 14th century stained glass. Saint-Ouen houses a famous Cavaillé Cole organ. The other church of note in Rouen is Saint-Maclou, from which our music comes today. This flamboyant Gothic church has an elaborately decorated west facade with a five-bay porch and carved wooden doors depicting scenes from the Bible. Numerous examples of beam timber framed houses can be seen in the old streets of Rouen, dating back to the 14th century to the 19th century. This was the preferred type of dwelling in a city which had little stone, but lots of oak in the surrounding forests.
Thank you.
One of the famous organs of Normandy is found in the St. Maclou Church of Rouen. The organ of the Église originally dates back to 1520 and 1541 by the builder Antoine Joselin. Over the years, various rebuilds and restorations have been made to the instrument, with the latest reconstruction by the firm Kern in Strasbourg. The organ contains 3 manuals and 34 registers. It was our delight to play this magnificent instrument. Why don't you join us in the organ loft?
Thank you.
I am standing in the old market square of Rouen. It was here that the old St. Vincent's Church used to stand until World War II, when it was destroyed on May 30th, 1944. It was also on May 30th, 1431, that Joan of Arc was martyred in this place. A new church has now been built here, and a memorial to Joan of Arc. On that memorial, we read these words: O Joan of Arc, without sepulcher and without portrait, you who knew that the tomb of a hero is in the heart of the living. Our musical journey of Normandy continues on to Le Havre, an important seaport of France and gateway to Europe. In our musical journey of Normandy, we visit Le Havre. Le Havre, a city with a population of over 200,000, is the second most important seaport in France. It is situated at the mouth of the Seine River on the English Channel. During World War II, the British bombed the city to prevent its use by the Germans for an invasion of England. Today, however, the city stands proudly overlooking its ships and beautiful yachting harbor. Thank you. Now, directly over the tomb of Saint Honorine, patron saint of bargemen, the cathedral in Le Havre was a place of pilgrimage. The church itself, constructed during the reigns of William the Conqueror and Henry II, is of Roman style, while the monastic buildings, built in the early 13th century, illustrate the Gothic Anglo-Norman style. Le Havre boasts one of the great organs of Normandy. The grand organ of the Cathedral Notre Dame in Le Havre originally dates back to 1637 and was completed by the famous organ builder Nicolas Lefebvre in 1772. As in most historic organs, modifications and reconstructions have been made to the instrument over the years. The organ today consists of 4 manuals and 42 registers.
Thank you.
Today, the Joy of Music has come to you from France as we have brought you a musical journey of Normandy. We hope you have enjoyed the beautiful sights and historic cathedrals and churches of this important region of France. Thank you for joining us on this musical journey of Normandy, and we look forward to seeing you again next week on the Joy of Music.
Diane, Bishs and the Joy of Music wish to thank Air France for their support in making this program possible.